Hi, I'm Exact Weather Meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on to your New Year's Eve day forecast and your web weather. Take a look right now. We've got cloud cover outside. That's our Lee Circle camera. And the clouds, yeah, it's going to stay soupy pretty much all day long. Now, the good news is I think we're stuck with the cloud cover, but I don't think we're going to see much fog. The lower levels are dry. Take a look at the satellite and radar imagery. We've been dealing with this west-southwesterly flow in the mid and upper levels. That's going to continue. And as you can see, down toward the south, that's not rain. That's going to be pretty much staying down toward our south. That green is. Now, let's talk almanac and let's talk temperatures. Yesterday's high was 58 degrees, and you can see that is trending below that average of 62. But look at this, 81. That's a record set back in 1990. So it can get pretty warm this time of year, and we don't want that. We want it to feel more like the holidays, and it will. Here's what you can expect over the next couple of days. Cloudy, overcast, staying unseasonably cool, but not too bad. The average of 62 will be in the 50s, running anywhere from 5 to 8 degrees below the seasonal average. Clouds, overcast tonight with maybe a stray shower. That should happen after the fireworks. And like I said, I think fog stays out of the picture. The only problem we may have as far as fireworks viewing go is those clouds start to lower. Hopefully the clouds will stay elevated enough to wick at the fireworks in underneath. And then tomorrow, cloudy, overcast, rain will be ramping up, increasing as we move through the day. Here's that southwesterly flow I'm talking about. You can see it moving all the way across Texas, Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama. It extends all the way up to the mid-Atlantic states, up the eastern seaboard. Now, what's going to happen is, in the upper levels, we've got a trough that's going to push through, eventually kick this out. Let's talk timing. We'll take a look at the forecast model. There's your area of high pressure. That will continue moving toward the east-northeast. The west-southwesterly flow will continue as we get to the midnight hour tonight, New Year's Eve, right around the time we're dropping the ball and watching the fireworks go off. Looks like we could get a little bit of clearing on the north shore, south shore. As you can see, it stays foggy. Once again, if the fog stays cloudy, I should say, if the fog stays away, we'll be in good shape. But if the clouds stay high enough, we'll be in good shape as well. Now, a couple of showers along the coast will be possible. You can see rain kind of lingers into Wednesday morning, New Year's Day morning. By 4 o'clock, rain really starts ramping up, moving into the picture. In addition to what we have going on down to the south, which is an area of low pressure we'll be developing, we've got a cold front that's going to be moving through. So this is overnight, Wednesday night. Into Thursday, you can see some of the rainfall potentially heavy there to the northwest, also down toward the south. So it looks like this is going to be an overnight rain event, overnight Wednesday into Thursday. Let's focus once again on New Year's Eve night when we're trying to watch the fireworks. You'll probably need a jacket. Temperatures will be staying mainly in the upper 40s from 9 p.m. roughly to about 3 a.m. for those of you staying out late. So we'll have just the clouds to deal with, fog, maybe a couple of isolated spots, but it's not going to be widespread and not going to be the main inhibiting factor if we get some sort of inhibiting factor, which would be the clouds lowering. Highs today, lower to mid-50s, so that is unseasonably cool. Temperatures overnight tonight, upper 40s to near 50, so your temperature range not very wide from morning to night, or from morning to day, I should say, and then into the nighttime. 30% chance of rain for tomorrow. That's only 30% because I think most of the rain arrives the latter part of New Year's Day. Overnight Thursday, rain will be sticking around, and I think as we get to Thursday afternoon, we clear out. That's why we only have a 20% chance of rain. Now, behind that cold front, it gets very, very cold. While we're going to have lots of sunshine on Friday, notice where we start, in the 20s and 30s, so it's really going to be getting cold after that front passes on Friday. Afternoon highs, they're going to be trending mainly in the upper 40s to lower 50s. I'm Exact Weather Meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on, and Happy New Year.